Welcome back to Let's Play The Legend of Zelda Skyward Sword. Last time, we entered the Lanayru Desert and explored a mighty fine chunk of it to get here to a ruined entrance to a ruined place. Sounds perfectly logical, and hey, the Goron's back! Good to see you, bud! Seems like you pop up everywhere, though I am one to talk. Anyway, bud, there is something I am dying to tell you. It is the discovery of the century. This is a sacred place known as the Temple of Time. No, not that Temple of Time. The Temple of Time. I could not believe my eyes when I saw a human who lives on the legendary Isle of the Goddess. It wore clothes just like the ones written in ancient manuscripts, and it looked just like you, bud. It came with another person, and they entered the temple. I wanted to chase after them. But then there was an explosion all of a sudden, and the entrance, well, you can see for yourself. I do not think we're getting past this mess. I just wish we could find out another way that's on the other side. And thus, we'd look for an alternate way inside, which, coincidentally, third dungeon. Who would have thunk it? Oh, I'm gonna hate the third dungeon so much. Out of every dungeon in this game, my least favorite, the one we're heading to right now. I don't particularly like it, but I don't hate it. So that's a thing. Gonna just hit that there. And we got another one of those little robot dudes. What would you even call them for that matter? I don't know. But you know what? I'm just gonna go all secret agent on them and like bombs away. Oh hey, we got someone looking at us. Well, while you look at me, bombs away. Nothing is safe from Link's wrath. That was scary, Vroom. Thanks for helping me. This is the Temple of Time. Within it, the sacred gate of time made by the goddess. It's my job to patrol the outside of the temple, Vroom. If you want to reach the gate of time, you'll need to pass through that door. Huh? You need another way in? Weep. Well, the Lanyru mining facility and the Temple of Time are connected underground. The Lanyru mining facility is right here. Open up that map, fool. This map, it looks inaccurate. I'm gonna fix it for you. No, wait, you're making it inaccurate. No, it's already accurate. You son of a bitch. The new mining facility is just ahead. Good luck. Yeah, this place was once full of greenery. Then again, you would have gotten that from all the grass here. Yeah, the robot changed the map to like 1,000 or so years in the past. So it's a very long time ago, and you are a liar, sir. You can't really ride us all the way across, but you need to get up to here for the other time shift stone. And oh boy, that time shift stone, I hate that one so much. Well, actually, no, I never really have trouble getting it. Then again, I played most of the time I played this game, it was on hero mode. So I've always had the maximum hero Skyward Strike, so screw all y'all about it. Yeah, timing. Then again, the biggest Skyward Strike would definitely do that for me. Items, go. Don't you do that to me. There was an ancient flower back there and I'm gonna get it. You can't make me not get it. I'm not going back into the minecart. See, was that so hard? Could have just let me have it, could you, Link? You just didn't want me to have it. Hi there. Welcome to die. Good evening. Shield bashing extraordinaire. Link, who would have thunk it? Then again, ever since when ever since Twilight Princess, he's been a master shield basher. Actually, that would be since this game, wouldn't it? Since this one's technically first in the timeline. Speaking of that Zelda timeline, no. No. That's all. No. Just no. That's all I have to say. Just no. Hi. I'm just gonna be blowing everything up while I can, because, you know, I have the technology, I'm gonna do it. There's nothing over there, so it's rather pointless for me to go there. Map. Right, with all these, pathway markers here, you can tell, where, Sing Sand is and isn't on the, map itself. Where there's grass here, it'll be Sing Sand, where there isn't, and it's like these pathways, there isn't Sing Sand, so you can just, like, walk over here. So that's good to know. Yes, V, thank you. And this is where V's gonna give us the option to use, more than one beacon. You can use it to mark your way, but really, you don't need to. But if you do, you're not thought of any less for it, but yeah, she just gives us more of them. You don't have to use them. She doesn't tell you to use them, so it's all fine and dandy in my book. So I'm just gonna run up along here. Hopefully I'll make it up. Yes! Made it. Okay, right, there's a way you can go about this. There are three things you have to activate. There's, if we look at the map right here, there's one here, another right here, and the last one's over here. Or in either way you want to go. You can do this any way you wish. And so there's a bit of freedom in that way, just like with the Kikui hunting back in Faron Woods. So there is a degree of freedom to how you want to go about this. But yeah, granted, it's all still very linear. Just saying, you have the option to do certain things. Just as long as I'm facing the right way. I'm not on the map. Okay, good. I'm actually on it this time. Good. I need to be on this thing if I'm going to do anything else around here. The only different thing about this is that whichever one you decide to go to is where the, I forget which buttons do which. What you want is the, holy crap! Holy crap! No! You don't get to do that anymore! Goodbye, you! Ow! That hurt like a bitch! Holy shit! That never happened before! Damn, that hurt. The thing is, for you to activate these three things, they're kind of like generators of sorts to activate the mining facility itself. But you gotta turn them with the Wii Remote, yay, motion control technology. Or infrared motion control technology. Make sure you make note of where these things are on the actual map itself. In relation to where the pedestal was back at back near the, this giant hole right here, yes, this giant hole. Just, there are three things we need to activate. There's one for water, electricity, and, fire. Just make sure you make note of where they are on the map, of where you are. How I wish I can easily turn the map around. But I can't do that, apparently. Apparently that only exists within the game to do that to me. But, really, you gotta make sure where the, symbols are on the map. Just be always cautious about that. Just gonna leave a bomb here. Actually, I wanna get away from that. There we go. We're gonna activate the, second one before we actually head anywhere else. Things about this, when you have, enemies from the present going into these things, they will pretty much instantly die. Same thing for anything that actually leaves this field. If they leave this, they die instantaneously. So, it's good to know. If anything from the past leaves its area of effect, they can't step out of it. Otherwise, they'll die. So, there's a nice stat for you. Marking that. Now, there's tumbleweed that likes to spawn around here a lot. When you're here, just make sure you always keep on the lookout for tumbleweed, because this is where a tumbleweed likes to spawn the most. No enemies around here to really tell you that, distract you from all the, tumbleweed that can possibly spawn. Just keep your eye out. Because tumbleweed's actually nice to have when you want to upgrade equipment. Is there anything here at all before I go inside? No? Nothing? No tumbleweed. Okay. Alright, let's get inside this thing and get this one out of the way. These things are actually... One of these later on is going to actually make use of your hook beetle, so be sure you keep that in mind, that you actually have that. The hook beetle can pick things up that are electrified. Just keep that in mind. If only because of the... It's a thing in this area that if you can, I think it's that one. It should be that one. I hope it is. I'm gonna stand behind this rock just in case. Yeah, it is. Okay, good. I'm standing behind this rock in case that thing comes back, i.e. spawns. So I don't have to worry about it ramming into me and then knocking me out cold. The things, they revert back to an earlier state of life, which is kinda cool, but you gotta deal with it, and you gotta put them in a little generator, and take you quickly. And there's another one. There are a lot of chests here. That's one thing you wanna keep in mind. Ouch. You, sir, are a pain, and I will take this chest and everything you had inside. 20 rupees? What a rip. Right, with you, I'm gonna just do this with you. Like I mentioned, the beetle can't pick up electrified objects, because if you carry this thing normally, periodically it will shock, and you will get hurt from it, and it's not that great. You want to have it, like, right there. Just keep it there, and then you can head on over to hit it in, and then, you'll have a working generator for all of 5 seconds. For a gate that you probably will never need ever again. Come on. Spin attack and fatal strike. Or fatal blow. Whatever. Who cares? It gets a blue rupee! Well, that was the biggest ripoff of the century. You there, There we go. Oh, he dropped something. Thank you for the skull, and I'm gonna just step on... Hey! Okay, well, it was a little line of dialogue. That I can forgive. I can forgive the line of dialogue. It was just one thing, and then she went away. I can forgive that. I can forgive. I'm not too cruel to be. Huh? I thought you were supposed to appear that other one and never appear here again. Unless I talk to you, then you don't appear again. Is that what it's supposed to go? Not so sure, because this is my second one I'm activating right now. Yeah, this is weird. Alrighty then, that's the second one activated. Only 13 minutes in. You know what, let's get that piece of heart I kept going on about. I'm gonna get that before I end this part, because piece of heart, man. You gotta have heart. You gotta have heart, y'all. Like Rod would say. Rod the Blade Sword, you gotta have heart. Look along here, you'll actually see things about like what Lanayru used to do. Apparently they shipped things, like 150 containers. As part of their quota. And they had floor supervisors. They actually had a society. Avoid workplace accidents. Safety first. They had a unique society here and then they went extinct. Like everything else in the Zelda universe. What doesn't go extinct here? Like everything in the Zelda universe at one point has to die. It doesn't matter what it is, it dies eventually. Sooner or later, it must die. That's how it is in the world of Zelda, apparently. No matter what your species, you will die eventually. That is just how it is, and it is very unfortunate, but everybody must die one day. And take this, I'm gonna need that, and... can just go along here. I really shouldn't do this till later, but you know what? A piece of heart, and screw y'all, I want it. And plus, we'll be coming back here later anyway, so what's the point in not getting it now? Well, the point in not getting it now would be to save it for later, so that way I actually get it later, and then along with everything else, and I have a checklist to actually keep myself up to date with my stuff, and, no. You, sir. Ouch. Then, though, my reckless habits, it might be good for me to get it now. And well, here's the jelly blob that you get for killing, choo-choos and whatnot. A lot of these are relatively useless in terms of upgrading what you want, so upgrade being your regular items, like, say, the beetle and the bug net. I'm too reckless, therefore I'm getting it now, I don't care. I know there's gonna be a big chew. Hi there. I'm just gonna grab this and head on out of here. So if you don't mind me getting your stuff, I'm just gonna grab this and... I'm gonna leave. I'm just gonna leave you alone and you can do your thing. Cause if you're allowed to do your thing, I should be allowed to do my thing and we should be able to live happily ever after. If that's cool with you, man, then it's cool with you. And then we can all be friends. This coming from the guy who slaughters a whole bunch of chews just to get to a freaking treasure chest that has a piece of heart. I slaughter everything. Then again, I don't slaughter a whole bunch of things. I don't slaughter a lot of things, actually. A lot of things I actually let live. Which is very odd considering how I have such a sadistic attitude towards many creatures in video games. I just kill them all because, you know what, screw it. All those Rattatas and Zubats? Yeah, screw it, I'm killing them all. Oh, you. Oh, no. No, 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 oh. I just got healed, too. Nope. I just got healed and I get hit again. Glorious day, Void. Ah. Everything keeps hitting me. Right. I don't need to be hit all the time. Activate that, and there's a shortcut here. Gonna activate that. There we go. Shortcut ho! And now I'm gonna enter the building. Because you know what? I'm hurting. A lot. Again. I hate those things. You can never dodge them. Well, unless you deliberately chase them into a wall and then move out of the way the last second, but that's very hard for me to do. Because timing! I don't have timing.